mama. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get it, park it like it's hot. We interrupt this program with a breaking news report.
Hello, Shane Dewar here, bringing you the latest on BT Corn. Did you know that corn is one of the most agricultural crops in the world? In the year of 2000, over 72 acres of corn were harvested with $15 billion worth of sales. The largest grower is the United States, which produced 241 million metric tons in 2001. It is estimated that each year, 40 million tons of corn will never reach the market because of damage by the corn borer. Damage control costs in North America alone exceed $1 billion per year in the United States.
This is $1 billion.
Do you want this to happen? Are you suffering from the infamous corn borer? Do you want us to be in even more debt? That's what I thought. You need BT corn. Through genetically engineering corn, scientists have fused Bacillus thuringiensis genes with its own. Commonly known as BT, Bacillus thuringiensis is a soil bacterium that produces insecticidal toxins. So when the European corn borer decides to eat it as a tasty snack, it will instantly die.
Here's a picture of the European corn borer.
Corn was chosen for genetic engineering because it will save the United States 40 million tons of corn per year. That's approximately $140 million. Also, BT corn improves control of the corn borer dramatically compared to other approaches. Not only does it provide better control against the pests, BT corn saves growers much time and effort in treating cornfields. If there's an outbreak, you need not to worry. It's better to be safe than sorry, as my mother used to say. Now over to Bob with the weather.
Rain!
So as I was saying, BT corn is produced by more than one company, so there might be some variation in particular ingredients and methodology. One example of a BT corn producing company is Novartis. It is a multinational pharmaceutical company based in Basel, Switzerland. It ranks number 3 in sales among the worldwide industry and, quote-unquote, markets innovative products to prevent and cure diseases, to ease suffering, and to enhance the quality of life. This product offers no harm to human health concerns, nor does it affect any other type of animal. It has not yet gone through the FDA approval, but that can be our dirty little secret. FDA tests take time, and the results of clinical trials are not always clear cuts. Thus, many tests are needed. It will likely take decades before a complete analysis on BT corn is finished, and if approved, may be available to the food industry eventually. However, environmental concerns include insects becoming resistant to the BT proteins. Also, BT corn has a negative effect on monarch butterfly larvae. Some research has shown that monarch butterfly who feed on milkweed leaves dusted with BT corn pollen suffer in a decline of fitness. These declines are sometimes enough to immobilize or potentially kill the monarch butterfly larvae. Because of the harm to the monarch in 1999, the UCS joined the National Wildlife Federation, the Sierra Club, the National Resources Defense Council, the Arizona Sonora Desert Museum, and the Defenders of Wildlife in petitioning the EPA for strict regulation of corn modified to reduce a large amount of BT toxin. Every country encourages the progress of this GMO because it can save millions of dollars and produce a much greater output of crops than before. It can be expected that the BT corn will continue to be evaluated by the FDA and will eventually be put onto the market. This promising crop might be a first step into a new form of agriculture and farming. We're talking a completely different genetically modified food industry where every plant is pest and disease resistant. BT corn might be the key into the world of genetically modified crops. Thanks for watching. This is Shane Dewar, and thank you for tuning into SMD News.
Now ladies, here we kiss her. When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. And if a get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Chandon, and I'm all the best cause I got it going on. I'm a bad boy.